for Development Commissioner, it is easy to believe that the world is always in the grip of one crisis or another. In the newspapers or on TV, there is often the worst kinds of news. I can understand that people sometimes think there is only bad news, and I believe worse still, that basically we can't do anything about it. In a relatively short period of time, Poland has managed to transform both its political and economical system. 30 years ago, a small group of workers established a trade union. Within a year, its membership grew to include 80% of the country's workforce. Solidarność went on to become a major political force, a major word in the history of the world. Solidarity's influence led to the spread of similar ideals and movements throughout the countries. And the success of Solidarity's candidates in the 1989 elections helped spark a succession of events which ultimately led to the enlargement of the European Union. In Poland, the word solidarity is to this day associated with the brave social movement, as also in the whole of Europe. But it also has a wider meaning, uniting together in a common cause to help also others in need. It has taken its place alongside the great men and women of Poland's recent past. And we cannot mention great men of Poland without also mentioning Ryszard Kapuściński himself. Well, I learned him just recently, but I really admire him as a brilliant journalist, writer, and storyteller. And he understood that sometimes you have to put yourself in the front line, rather than stay in comfort zone of the newsroom. So imagine if Kapuściński had been there in the aftermath of the devastating earthquake which struck Haiti. Imagine the tales of destruction and destitution told through his words. Well, just 3 weeks ago, I have been in Haiti. I was able to see for myself the destruction caused by the earthquake. I saw the refugee camps and walked among the rubbles that were once homes, schools, and hospitals. The scale of tragedy is immense, but it also made me realize of EU's development policy. But development policy also goes much further than our natural instinct to help others in need. The aid Europeans are giving is not a panacea. It must be more a catalyst for a change. Our commitment must be measured by more than just euros and zlotys we spend. The aim of development is not only to give people enough food for today, but to help them build better tomorrow for themselves and their children. It's about learning from experiences, sharing ideas, values, and understanding opportunities. That is why Poland has so much to contribute to Europe's development policy. Poland's familiarity with transition, the lessons of democratic change and economic reform are qualities that have inspired your neighbors. They can also inspire Europe's interest and solidarity with developing countries across the world. Poppies in Afghanistan, unfortunately becoming heroin in our capitals. Or pollution from Indian industries melting the ice caps in the Arctic. We cannot shield ourselves from such challenges beyond our borders. Many of these have their roots in poverty and underdevelopment. Our development policy must be about the long-term response to the threats, because we cannot tackle poverty without taking account of global challenges such as climate change, security, migration, or trade. There is indeed no possibility for development without security, and no chance of security for any of us without development for every world citizen. To keep our promises to increase aid. It will be far from simple to meet our commitments in today's economic and financial environment. But if we do not meet our promises on development policies, I believe we lose the most important things that you can lose: credibility and trust. And solidarity means delivering on commitments to help to tackle poverty. The action plan is also getting better value for aid, making it more effective. And it is a plan for ensuring other European policies, such as trade and migration, also work for development. In setting out how Europe can keep its promises, we also want the rest of international community to play its part. We have put forward ideas about how developing countries themselves can increase own resources. This means involving them in an international effort to tackle tax evasion, as well as strengthening their tax systems at home. Europe can export to the world the solidarity that was made in Poland. As we look ahead to next year, Poland will play a key role in the European Union. The presidency in the second half of 2011 will be a chance to raise the profile of development. Raising public awareness of development in Poland is definitely also one of the priorities, as in other member countries. I am pleased that next year's edition of European Development Days will take place here. And I'm also very much pleased that 83% of Polish citizens support development policy's objectives.